Narcissists are known to use a variety of tactics and defenses to ensure their needs are met. That's it. At the expense of their victims' insecurities, of course. But different narcissists are known to have different motives and use their own set of tactics to get what they want. So, what type of narcissist are you dealing with? Welcome back, Psychos. Today, we'll be talking about four types of narcissists. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel, as well as click the notification bell so that you never miss a video. Number 1. The typical narcissist. Although there are different subtypes of narcissistic behavior, the typical narcissist is the Hollywood film explanation of a narcissist and probably the one you know best. They're your average grandiose personality type with all of their attention-seeking extroverted ways. This typical type of narcissist is self-absorbed, entitled, exploitative, aggressive, and authoritarian. They think extremely highly of themselves while paying little attention to the feelings of others. In fact, they achieve their goals at the expense of other people's feelings and well-being. Typical narcissists don't care what others think of them because they think so highly of themselves. Their high confidence and extrovertedness usually results in these narcissists being highly satisfied with their lives with high self-esteem. The key attribute that differs this narcissistic type from the others is that they seek attention and domination, so their narcissism is very externalized. They wear their narcissism on their sleeves, seducing and charming people into giving them what they want for themselves. Number 2. The introverted narcissist. The introverted or vulnerable narcissist poses all the same threats as the typical narcissist, such as lack of empathy, self-absorption, self-entitlement, manipulation, and aggressive behavior. Yet, they fear the criticism of others to the point of shying away from attention. Introverted narcissists are often deeply insecure and unsatisfied with their lives compared to the typical narcissist, who feels much more confident and self-satisfied. These narcissists are referred to as the vulnerable type because they experience more distress, anxiety, guilt, depression, hypersensitivity, and shame, according to PsychCentral.com. These vulnerable narcissists are known to experience the typical narcissism traits like imposter syndrome and a weak sense of self at a much greater degree than the typical narcissist. It's like they're stuck in between having an irrational, grandiose image of themselves and a deeply toxic, negative one, which they then project onto the other people around them. The introverted nature of this type of narcissist requires a stealthy manipulation tactic, so they tend to use an avoidant or anxious attachment style. In fact, these narcissists usually rope people in with guilt, misery, resulting in their victims unknowingly self-sacrificing to rescue them. Number 3. The communal narcissist. The communal narcissist is stealthy and often very hard to detect. These narcissists actually value warmth, connection, and how others view them. Their main mission is to see themselves and be seen by others as trustworthy and supportive beyond means, and they usually achieve this through their friendly, kind personalities. So, what's wrong about wanting to be supportive and kind? Well, similar to the typical narcissist, the communal narcissist exhibits an extroverted personality, yet unlike the typical narcissist who seeks to be the smartest and most powerful person in the group, communal narcissists want to be seen as the most giving and helpful. The unfortunate thing is that communal narcissists want to be seen as the most giving and helpful as an ego boost rather than a genuine motive to help others. Their kind and helpful ways are only there to satisfy their motive of grandiosity, power, and recognition. Number 4. The malignant narcissist. Lastly, we have the malignant narcissist, the worst of them all. The one that you want to stay far, far away from. Malignant narcissists are known to be on the extreme end of the narcissism spectrum because of their degree of cruelty and aggressiveness. Their motive is beyond grandiose power. In fact, they take pride and pleasure out of creating chaos and tearing people down. They are known to be less social than the typical narcissist, to the point of being antisocial with traits of paranoia. They do still seek power and a sense of importance, but malignant narcissists are actually considered to be closer related to having an antisocial personality disorder or psychopathic tendencies than they are to the other type of narcissism. This narcissism is much easier to point out because their charm is so quickly overridden by aggressiveness. Well, that's it for today's video, Psychos. So which narcissist type sounds more familiar to you? Let us know in the comments below. Also, make sure to leave us a like, share this video with your friends, and also subscribe to our channel for more Psycho videos. We'll see you in the next one.